Hi, my name is Sylvie, and I help women look great and feel great through fasting and whole food nutrition. In today's video, I am going to share my before and after pictures of intermittent fasting. It's been about a year now that I've been experimenting with intermittent fasting with or without keto. And when I was sharing about my 14-day keto experiment, one of my viewers said that I should share before and after pictures. And so I thought, you know what? It's probably about time that I share my before and after pictures of intermittent fasting. I know that most of us are quite visual, and it is really helpful and motivating to see other people, their results, and what it looks like. So not only today I'll share these before and after pictures with you, but I will also give you 6 steps that you can follow if you want to achieve similar results. My before pictures date from about a year ago at different times, but you'll see they're all very similar because it's before I started losing weight. I'm 5'10", and in these pictures I weighed about 170 pounds. My waist measurement was 31 inches and my hips were 41 inches. Now my weight ranges between 146 pounds and 149 pounds, depending on what time of the month it is and how diligent I have been with maintaining my intermittent fasting regimen. My waist is now 28 inches and my hips are 38 inches. Okay, so now that you saw my results, you saw the pictures, finally, you know what my before and after pictures of intermittent fasting look like. How about I give you my step-by-step strategy so that you can achieve these results? If you've known me for a while, watched some of my videos, you know that my weight loss journey was not an easy one. I am 43 years old, and just like any other perimenopausal woman, losing weight was not easy, particularly considering the fact that I am not an all-or-nothing person when it comes to trying new diets. I tend to jump in different ideas. I last 3 days and then I give up. I don't like going hungry. I don't like depriving myself. So if I can do it, you can do it too. And I will share with you what made a difference this time over the last year and why I was finally able to succeed. My step number one is start with modified fasting or the keto diet. I believe that modified fasting was a turning point for me. I had done intermittent fasting previously and I felt hungry, I hated it, and I was not seeing enough results. However, as I started learning about the benefits of fasting, and particularly the fasting mimicking diet by Dr. Walter Longo, I was intrigued. And I decided that I was going to try it. And that's what I did. I did a modified fast. That's what I call it, because the fasting mimicking diet is a trademark and it is sold as a kit. So I created my own version. I call it modified fasting. And basically it's a 5-day fast that allows you around 800 calories a day. So that kind of severe calorie restriction really helps heal your body, stabilize your insulin level, and it will also help you get started, prime your body to become more metabolically flexible, which will really help with intermittent fasting in general. Another option is the keto diet. And as I mentioned in the introduction of this video, I have experimenting a little bit with the keto diet. I did a 14-day experiment, which I really enjoyed, by the way. I was going to keep it up because I felt great and I was really happy with my results. And I ended up not really sticking with it. I still prefer doing the warrior diet most days. Basically, I practice intermittent fasting without keto. But if you want quicker results, I would definitely recommend that you also do the keto diet. I have a 7-day meal plan. It's super simple. All the macros, the calories, everything is presented in the meal plan. It's a PDF file. I'll leave a link in the description below. If you would like to download it, go check it out. But it is possible to achieve the results you want without the keto diet. It's really a matter of experimenting and finding what works for you. Oh yeah, and I will also leave a link to help you get started with modified fasting in the description if that is what you would prefer. And step number two, I would recommend you choose a weekly intermittent fasting. As you get started with intermittent fasting, even if you did a modified fast or a 7-day cycle of the keto diet, you may find it beneficial to start your intermittent fasting with a type of intermittent fasting that does not require you to do it every single day. And that's another thing that I did this time that I feel really helped me. The reason I found it helpful is that I knew I didn't have to do it every day. And if you are like me and you struggle with sticking to a new lifestyle long term or even short term, like a week, you may enjoy doing an intermittent fasting method that you only have to worry about doing twice a week. And when I got started this time around with intermittent fasting, I did a combination of the eat, stop, eat method and the 5-2 method. The eat, stop, eat method involves fasting for 24 hours, once or twice a week. You can have your dinner one night. You start your fast after dinner, and then the next day you can have dinner again. So it doesn't seem that bad. Although obviously the second night your dinner will be later to give you that 24-hour stretch, but you still get to eat even though it's a little bit later, which is really nice. Another option is the 5-2 method. And the 5-2 method again is twice a week and you eat 500 calories on your fasting days. It is really helpful to have these calories if you again are new to fasting and struggle with going without food. You may enjoy this method. I will leave a link in the description where you'll find more information about the 5-2 method and also meal plan ideas. Step 3 is fast for 20 hours a day, but take the weekends off. Once you practice for a while these intermittent fasting methods that you do not have to do every single day, you may be ready to graduate to something that you do more frequently. And when you do so, I recommend that you fast longer, like 20 hours a day. That is another thing that made a big difference for me this time around. For most women, fasting only 16 hours a day isn't enough. An 8-hour window is ample time to overeat. And I'm just gonna share a quick overview of a sample day for me on the warrior diet. I usually fast until around 3 or 4 in the afternoon. Before that, I drink coffee. When I break my fast, I like to drink a power shake. I love the power shake because it is filled with vitamins and minerals. It is made with raw organic superfoods and it is filling and satisfying. That's my favorite way to break my fast. Then about an hour later, if I am hungry before eating dinner with the rest of the family, I will make myself a large salad. Then I have dinner with the rest of the family, which I feel is really helpful. Any intermittent fasting method that allows you to enjoy dinner with the rest of the family is awesome in my mind. And then in the evening, I may eat a snack. So that's what a sample day looks like for me. Step 4 is monitor your progress. It is essential that you monitor your progress to see if whatever you're doing is working. It's kind of obvious. You need to track your weight and step on the scale maybe 2 or 3 times a week. Also take hips and waist measurements before pictures. And keep in mind that even though sometimes your weight may not budge a lot, other things may change. Your waist measurements may be decreasing, your face may be slimming down. And so that's why it's a good idea to have more than one way to track your progress. But I do find that as a general rule, my weight is usually what I go by. I just don't weigh myself every single day because it's normal to have weight fluctuations throughout the week and even throughout the month. But as you get to know your fluctuations, you know, you feel pretty confident in knowing if you're on an upward trend, if you're on a downward trend, and you get to know what's going on with your body and if what you're doing is working. And step five is to adjust as needed. After monitoring your progress, if you are happy with your results, well, keep doing what you're doing. If you're not happy with your results, you're not losing enough weight, there's a few questions you can ask yourself. Are my expectations realistic? Many women enter their weight loss journey with unrealistic expectations, thinking that they're gonna lose 10 pounds in a month. And I can't really blame them. There are so many misleading articles out there that claim that you will do just that. But I am here to encourage you that weight loss takes time, but it's a good thing because if you achieve a sustainable weight loss over a longer period of time, chances are you will keep up your weight loss and not gain all the weight back. When it takes you longer to lose the weight that you are losing, it's because you're not starving yourself and you are doing a diet that you can sustain long term and that becomes part of you. It becomes part of your habits. Over the course of the last year, my weight loss was typically 2 pounds a month, which isn't that much, right? And some months I wouldn't even lose any weight at all. And then another month I would lose 4 pounds or even 5 pounds, but that was not very often. Another question you can ask yourself is, are you really eating only during a 4-hour window? Sometimes you may start taking a bite here and there outside of your eating window, and you may find that without you even noticing, your eating window is no longer a four hour eating window, and like you're snacking at 1 PM, and so you're breaking your fast. That's something that happened to me sometimes, and it may happen to you too, so keep track of when you're eating and make sure that no food crosses your lips until the set time where you are supposed to break your fast. And make that moment where you are breaking your fast special. Make sure you enjoy that first food that you are consuming. Are you binge eating during your eating window? Sometimes that happens. People who practice intermittent fasting feel justified to start binge eating when they break their fast. They're hungry and they just want to eat everything in sight. Lastly, should I try a different intermittent fasting method? So let's say you've been doing the warrior diet 7 days a week for a month and you haven't lost more than 2 pounds and you're getting discouraged. Well, look at other methods. There's other things you can do. We're all different. There's an intermittent fasting method that works best for each of us out there. It's just that you need to find it. And also a method that works for a while may not work long term necessarily, and you may have to play around some more. And if you are not seeing the results that you are looking for on the warrior diet, alternate day fasting is a method that I would recommend you try. Many women who struggle losing weight, even on the OMAD diet, which is just one meal a day, a 1-hour eating window, find that they finally get the results that they have been looking for on the alternate day fasting method. And just as a quick overview, the alternate day fasting method means that you are fasting for 36 hours twice a week. Another method that may work best for you is TUMAD. TUMAD is great because it is not just about looking at the clock, it's about getting two meals a day. And when you get your two meals may vary from day to day, but you are making sure that you're only eating two meals and you're not eating snacks, so you will not overindulge. And that may be beneficial, and you may find that it works better for you. Step six is move on to maintenance mode. After achieving the results that you had been looking for, congratulations, it's great. But I just want to make sure that you do not revert back to your old habits. If you want to sustain your weight loss and not gain the weight back, you need to keep practicing intermittent fasting. You may be able to play around with whatever method you were using. You may be able to loosen your eating window and enjoy more treats. But you have to be consistent in checking your weight. For one thing, I would recommend that you keep weighing yourself maybe 2 or 3 times a week to make sure that you're not gaining the weight back. It's easy to gain 5 pounds and not even notice. So if you keep weighing yourself, you'll see if you're starting to gain weight, and then you can cut back on your eating hours or your snacks or whatever you're doing. I also like to keep 2 days a week that I am strict again with my fasting. So now that I have achieved my weight loss results, I sometimes eat just because I'm hungry. I don't necessarily pay attention to my eating windows as much, although I do like to fast still. I still usually don't eat until 1 in the afternoon at least, but I don't necessarily fast for 20 hours every day. But I like to make sure I do fast for 20 hours twice a week, because intermittent fasting and fasting is not just about weight loss. And I think we all know that there are a lot of other benefits, and I enjoy how I feel when I keep it up like that. So I recommend you do the same thing. So that's it. Now is the time for you to get the results that you want so that you can have your own before and after pictures of intermittent fasting to show off and be proud of. And I am happy to help you on your intermittent fasting weight loss journey. I have lots of videos if you check out my channel. And if you have questions, comment in any of my videos. I try to always respond, and I take suggestions for more videos very seriously. I have lots of videos that I created in response to different comments. I really appreciate you, and see you next week.